Etiquette, the least you need to know, and afternoon tea etiquette. If you would like to order my books, please make sure to email me at info@jamilamusaiba.com. I'll link it down below here as well in the description box. If you are a new viewer on my channel, welcome. Here I talk about etiquette, soft skills, self-development, and sometimes a little bit about beauty and fashion. So if you're interested in all of that, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified every time I upload a new video. And if you're a returning viewer, welcome back to my channel. I'm delighted to see you here. So this has been a really long awaited, much requested video about my nighttime skincare routine. I read all your comments, I try to listen and deliver as requested. So without further ado, here we go, my nighttime skincare routine. The format of this video is going to be a little bit different from the videos that you see on YouTube about nighttime skincare routine, which is just carried out in a bathroom. And the reason it's like that is because I am a skincare junkie. I love collecting and trying different kind of creams. I go back to some that I really, really love, and then I always like trying new things. So I have this whole basket of the things I want to show to you. And then I will also do my routine in the bathroom. So you're going to see how I'm applying my creams and I'm washing my face. So it's all going to be visible to you, but please be patient because I have a lot of creams to show it to you. But before I get to open my Pandora box and show you what's inside, I think that nighttime skincare routine is a lot more than just the creams that you're using, but it's really the right kind of atmosphere and the correct kind of pajamas and pillowcase and aromas that you use in your bedroom, because it's really preparing your whole skin, so not just your face but your entire body, to good sleep, which is essential for a good skin. So first things first, a good nighttime skincare routine is selecting the right kind of pajamas. I'm wearing the ones by Lily Silk, and this is a silk pajama. It is super lightweight, very, very soft and gentle on your skin. It feels like someone is caressing me in a way. I love that it keeps my body cool, but it kind of wraps it in a very gentle way. And I love that feeling going into bed. And the best benefits of wearing silk is that it's antibacterial and it's hypoallergenic. So I'm a person that has a very dry and sensitive skin, so my skin gets irritated very, very easily. And wearing silk is just making sure that it doesn't get irritated by anything. And what I love about wearing silk, I think it also makes you look very elegant and very pampered, almost like you are going to spa. And I just generally love the way that this set looks on me and the color looks on me. So when I put these pajamas on, I already feel fancy, and I put on some really nice incense sticks, and then I start my nighttime skincare routine. Speaking of silk, I also have this matching silk scrunchies by Lily Silk. They match the color of my pajamas, and they have a huge variety of colors you can choose from. So you can just mix and match your scrunchie and your pajamas, or you can match them like I do. I love when it's all uniform look. And what I love about this scrunchies, actually, after I've discovered the silk scrunchies, I stopped using the regular ones because the other ones pull down your hair, and it can cause hair loss, and it just messes up your hair when you go to bed. So what I do is I'll put my hair in a braid, or I'll just put it together and then tie it lightly in a silk scrunch, that way making sure that my hair stays the same, especially when I have a couple of shoots to do. Let's say I have two shoots back in a day after day, then I'll get a blow dry on the first day and I want to make sure that I have the same kind of hairstyle for 2 days. So I will just lightly put it into a silk scrunchie, and therefore make sure that I have the same kind of hairstyle the next day. So this really saves the day, and it's really good for your hair as well. I also love wearing an eye mask. I cannot imagine myself falling to sleep without an eye mask. I also always travel with an eye mask. So in the airport or on the plane, when the lights are on, you can't fall asleep. So having your own eye mask is important. I don't like the ones that they provide at the on the plane. And what I love doing is I love spraying a little bit of my pillow mist on my eye mask before I go to bed. So just a little bit of that. And then when you fall asleep and you put it on your eyes, you can actually smell the mist. And mine is a lavender one, so it makes you calm down and it makes me just relax and fall into sleep much faster. And the most important step when it comes to nighttime skincare routine is making sure that you choose the right kind of pillowcase. and that is a silk pillowcase. Ever since I read about silk pillowcases, so this one is again by Lily Silk. It's matching my pajama and I love it. And even just looking at this color makes me feel so happy and so relaxed and so excited to fall asleep. So the benefits of silk, as I already mentioned, is being antibacterial and being hypoallergenic, but also the silk pillowcase makes sure that you don't get any lines or wrinkles on your face. So in the long run, it's taking care of your skin. Something very funny happened to me a while back when I didn't know about silk pillowcases is I love napping between whenever I had time between Zoom calls. And because I love wrapping the pillow around my face, I would wake up and have these lines on my face. And when I was about to join Zoom call, I had to apply a lot of cover up, or I had to wait for my skin to calm down and get rid of these lines from the pillow to join a Zoom call. But ever since I discovered silk pillowcases, this has not been an issue for me. I can wrap my face all I want around the pillow and still have no lines at all. So in the long run, make sure that you switch to silk, because in the long run it's going to help protect your skin from fine lines and wrinkles. So now let's get into my Pandora box and see what I have inside. If you have seen my aromatherapy video, you probably know that I'm very much into scents, and for me it's very important to get myself in the right mindset before falling asleep. So I always start my nighttime skincare routine with this little incense sticks that I love, and I've been using them for a really long time. These ones are Japanese and they're traditional Japanese. It's called Morning Star and it's a lavender scent. Lavender generally calms your mind and makes you feel relaxed. So a lot of the products I'm using at night are of a lavender scent. So I first put on the incense stick and then I start my ritual. So then the first step in taking care of my skin is making sure that I cleanse it, and I cleanse it twice. I have been double cleansing ever since I have known myself. It has been more intuitive. I didn't know about the importance of double cleansing. I just wanted to make sure that I could get off all the makeup that I had on my skin throughout the day. Perhaps the two most important things that I've been doing in order to take care of my skin is I've never gone to bed with a makeup on, no matter how late I came, how tired I was. Always take off your makeup. It is going to serve you in the long run. And second, I've never used makeup wipes, not even once, even when I was super tired. And of course, using makeup wipes is very, very easy to do, but I don't like it. I don't feel like my skin is being cleansed well. So I always start by taking off my makeup using this Bioderma Sensibio. It's for sensitive skin and it's a micellar water that's a makeup remover, both for eyes and your face. And I can't just recommend this enough. I've been using it forever. And the good thing about it is, like, it doesn't, especially for sensitive skin that are prone to becoming itchy after certain kind of cleansers, this one is very, very safe and it's very gentle on your skin. So the first step is always taking off my makeup with this. The second skincare product that I've been loyal to, apart from Bioderma, is the second step of cleansing, and that is the Elemis Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm. I've showed this one in my older first video about skincare products that I use. I've been loyal to this product forever, ever since I tried it for the first time. I'm a skincare junkie, so I keep on trying new products, exploring new ones, but I always go back to this one. I have a super sensitive skin and a very dry one, so this is very good for my skin. Again, your skin type can be different and you might not like it because it's a little bit more oily. But what I love about it is that it's oily, it's very gentle in your skin, it takes off all the makeup without really stripping your face of, you know, natural oils. And I also love the scent of this Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm. It smells like you're in a forest. It smells like of trees. I don't know. It has a very natural scent. I personally really love that. And even a little bit of it goes a really long way. These ones are very difficult to find, or I just don't have the luck to find them very often. So whenever I find one bottle, I make sure that I buy all of it, whatever they have in store. Please don't keep on buying this because I cannot find these products afterwards. But this is my secret, super favorite product of all. After I've cleansed my face with Bioderma and Elemis, I always use tonic water. I never understood the benefit of it. I never knew that it was important, especially in my college years. No one told me that it had to be used. But then once a dermatologist told me that, you know, because our waters are not always very clean in a way, or they change the pH of our skin, it's important to use tonic water to rehydrate and bring back that pH level of your skin to the correct one. So I am not a dermatologist, I might not use the right terms to explain it, but really incorporating tonic water is very important, and I've been using it for about 6-7 years, and again the similar product for many years. I've tried all different kind of tonic waters, but I keep on going to Bioderma, and I really love this one. The Bioderma tonic water is the one I use on a regular basis, but sometimes I like to give my skin a splash of new experience, so to speak. So I've incorporated this Pixi Retinol Tonic into my skincare routine. So I would use it, let's say, twice a week to kind of give my skin a new experience and to shock it in a way. I don't use it on a daily basis, but once in a while I do use that, and either this or Bioderma is my third step in a skincare routine. Oh, one thing I forgot to show is that when I have a lot of makeup on my eyes, if I have done them professionally and there's a lot of eyeliner or heavier makeup on my eyes, Bioderma one is good at taking off lighter makeup, but if you want to take off your makeup that's super heavy on your eyes, then the one, this Biofacil Non-Oily Instant Cleanser by Lancome, is a really good one. I've been using it for many years, and I like that it's very soft and gentle. So especially, for example, if you have a very heavy liner or glued eyelash and it's very difficult to get it off, you just soak the cotton pads, you just leave it on your eyes and just gently wipe them off without really having to rub your eyes to get the makeup off. So it's a much recommended product. So far I've shown you the three cleansers, Bioderma, Elemis, and Lancome. I've shown you the tonic water that I use, either Pixi or again Bioderma one, and then I go into my serums. So I like to experiment with different kind of serums, but the two ones that I've selected so far for a couple of time is this one by Clarins and this one by Estee Lauder. I keep on switching between them. I don't just use one serum for a really long time. I will use one twice a week and then the other, let's say, the rest of the days, or I'll use this one for 2 times and then this one for 5 days. So I like switching between the two, and usually the way I choose them is however my skin feels that day. So if I feel like I could go for something stronger, I will go for something. If it needs more nourishment, I'll use. So this one is a double serum. It's hydric and lipidic system. It's anti-age. So this one is a little bit more oily, more nourishing. So I'll use this one if I feel like my skin needs it. If not, then I'll use this Perfections Pro. This is with vitamin C and it's brightening. So you have to be very careful when you use it during the summertime, but it's a great one to be used in fall and winter. So I keep switching between these two products. Next, an important step in my routine, actually two steps. I have been, again, watching all kind of YouTube videos about nighttime skincare routine, and thanks to those videos, I've learned about two important products that I didn't know ever before. I've been using these products for about 2 years, maybe a little bit more. So one is the retinol, which is a thing I swear by, amazing, and vitamin C. So these two products are the ones that I didn't know about when I was in college. It's something that I have recently discovered. Well, recently, for maybe 2 years. So this is by No. 7. It's an advanced retinol 1.5 complex. I use just a little bit all over my face and also my neck. I never forget about my neck. Again, you have to be very careful starting with retinol. My skin is very sensitive, but after all these steps with serums and all kind of creams, I feel like it's ready to absorb the retinol. So I've been using this, and so far I haven't had any reaction on my skin. And then I will alternate between retinol and vitamin C. I've seen a lot of videos where I recommend using vitamin C during the daytime, so in the morning routine, and retinol at night. because where I live there's a lot of sun, especially in summertime, I can't use vitamin C during the morning time. So what I do is I'll use, let's say, 3 or 4 times a week I'll use retinol, and the rest of the time I'll use vitamin C after my serum. So these are the steps that I'm taking. After retinol or vitamin C, I'll go into something that is more nourishing and richer cream, depending on the type of a season and again my skin feels. I will either use the SkinCeuticals one, Metacell Renewal, which is it is taking care of your photoaging symptoms and it's retightening the surface. It's really good, it's very light, so it's an amazing product to be used in the summer. I prefer to use something lighter in the summer because I don't love going to bed feeling like it has a lot of things on my skin when it's summertime. But when it's wintertime, then I go for something more heavier, like this Biopure Reoxygen Intense. It feels very lightweight, but it's very, very nourishing. So I like using it after the retinol or the vitamin C that I've used. I also really love oils, and I love incorporating them to my skincare routine. The two oils that I've been using for, again, as well, a really long time, I keep on trying different ones, but I keep on going back to these products, is one by Clarence, and it's a Blue Orchard Treatment Oil. The way I chose this oil, actually, they have 3 different ones, is against smelling and feeling like my skin needs this one. This is actually for dehydrated skin, and it was really funny when I chose it for the very first time, I chose it based on scent, and only after I read what kind of skin type it is for, I realized that actually your senses are the best judges when it comes to choosing the right kind of creams, because you will know what your body needs when you feel or smell the cream. And there is this one by Anna Simonin, and it's a Fita Rosa serum. It's a glow enhancer. I sometimes use it in my nighttime skin routine, but oftentimes I use it as a base before the makeup. So it makes the makeup really delicate on your skin, and it's really well absorbed to your skin once you first apply this as a first step. After I am done with taking care of my skin and neck, I go in with this Filorga Oxygen Glow Eye Cream. I put just a little bit under my eyes. I never used to really believe a lot in eye creams, but again, as I get older, I realize that eye cream is super important, and especially for people with dry skin, we tend to get really fine wrinkles, and if you smile a lot, you tend to get a lot of really fine wrinkles around your eye. So do not underestimate the power of a good eye cream. Another product that I have in my nighttime skincare routine, but I'm very careful when I use it because I have a dry skin, it is this Dr. Barbastorm Enzyme Cleanser. It is this powder, really little soft granules, and then you add a little bit of water, you foam it up, you apply it on your face. It really cleanses your skin so, so well. You feel super clean afterwards. But because I have a dry skin, I try not to overuse it. So I use it once a week usually, sometimes twice a week, depending on how often I've gotten makeup done or how dirty or polluted I feel like my skin is. So it depends really. And the final thing I do once I've, you know, applied all the creams and everything is something that I, again, swear by, live by. I have a lot of bottles everywhere in my bathroom, on my bedstand, in my bag, everywhere. Is this Caudalie Eau de Beauté, which is just a water, and it smells like you're at the spa. It has this really woody, like foresty smell. I love it. I just spray it all over my face, my neck, sometimes even my pillow, and that's it. I'm ready for sleep. And once I'm done with my skincare routine, I make sure that I don't forget about my hands. So my nighttime skincare routine always ends with a good hand cream. This is the one I've shown in a lot of my other videos. I love this Chanel hand cream. It's super rich, it's very soft on your skin. It feels like you're wearing gloves once you apply it. I make sure that I apply a lot of it before going to bed, because sometimes during the daytime I forget to apply it, or I'm in a rush or teaching a lot and don't have time to apply it, and my skin on my hands doesn't get enough attention. So before going to bed, I make sure I take care of my hands as well, because usually people start showing the first signs of aging on their hands and on their neck. So an important element of skincare routine is making sure you pay attention to your hands as well as your neck. So these were some of my favorite nighttime skincare products. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. Please do let me know in the comment section below what are some of your favorite products, maybe from the ones that I'm using, or maybe some of your personal favorite products. I would like to take a look at them because I love learning about new products. And this is a rather easy, I think, nighttime routine, a very sustainable one. I've been able to sustain it with having two kids. So if I can do it, you can do it too. I hope that you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.